Hi, I'm Steggy from Elgato, and this is Adobe Photoshop, and this is Stream Deck. And today, we'd like to announce version 1 of our Photoshop Stream Deck plugin. Wow, can you believe that was 6 months ago? Feels like just yesterday. It's crazy how time flies. Because today, we're announcing Adobe Photoshop 2.0 for Stream Deck. In this update, we've nearly tripled the amount of actions you can use to control Photoshop with your Stream Deck, turning Stream Deck into even more of the ultimate companion for your image editing needs. Let's go over some of the features in this new update. Now, one of my favorite parts about this update are the actions which don't have hotkey counterparts. So, using the rasterized layer type action, you don't have to right-click and search for the seemingly moving option to do this. You can just press a Stream Deck key, and now the image or text you rasterized is fully editable. If you need to quickly separate a subject from the background, you can press the Select Subject key, and Photoshop does this in a snap. And of course, if you need to tweak what Photoshop selects at all, you can always use the Quick Selection tool to make those edits. Now, one of the most popular functions in Photoshop are adjustment layers. And now with Stream Deck, you can create keys that will create your favorite adjustment layers. So, if you're like me, and you rely on a few types of adjustment layers more than others, with Stream Deck, you can have a speed dial for them. The new update for Stream Deck Photoshop also adds some really great actions that I think are quite commonly reached for. Things like transforming layers can now be done on your Stream Deck, so if you want to just free transform, distort, skew, or just rotate the layer by set amounts, it's incredibly easy to do so. Or one of my favorite Photoshop functions, Content Aware, is now available at the touch of a button. And let me ask you, how often do you change your foreground and background colors in Photoshop? Because now you can create preset keys to quickly switch to commonly used color schemes. So think about when you default back to the black foreground, white background colors. Now you can do this with any color combination you want. The last LCD key action for Stream Deck's Photoshop 2.0 is image size. So if you need to quickly optimize your image size for uploading to different destinations, you're just one tap away. And for Stream Deck Plus owners, we've added a lot of great new dial actions as well. You can adjust your layer's opacity, you can adjust brightness and contrast, you can zoom in on your document or rotate your document, and lastly, you can control your brush attributes like its size, hardness, flow, smoothness, and more. I think I might have got all of them. And yes, these actions can also be assigned to LCD keys as well in case you don't have a Stream Deck Plus. But in my opinion, being able to just dial in these actions is just such a great experience, you'll wonder how you ever got by with just a mouse and keyboard alone. So this is Photoshop 2.0 for Stream Deck. I hope you're as excited about it as I am. As always, we really welcome feedback in case we either miss some really often used actions, or if there's any improvements we can make to the existing actions. So be sure to leave a comment down below, or join our Discord to pass along your feedback to me and other Elgato employees. Now, to talk about the road ahead, we're shifting gears a bit. Now, our goal is to move through the Adobe software suite, adding support for Stream Deck, and our sights are currently set on Lightroom, where we have a number of actions spec'd out and are currently gearing up to execute on that plan. So, if you're a Lightroom user, be sure to keep your eyes peeled because we'll hope to launch that as soon as we can. Now, if you have suggestions for the next Adobe software we should tackle after Lightroom, such as Premiere, After Effects, Illustrator, or something else, be sure to let us know in the comments section or in our Discord. Now, to be clear, we're not hitting the brakes on Photoshop, but instead of big updates like this where we add 15 new actions all at once, expect smaller updates where we have fixes to actions or maybe 1 to 2 additions at a time so we can continue to expand our Adobe plugin through more apps while still optimizing the Photoshop plugin to give you the best experience possible. So like I said, join the conversation and let your voice be heard. And don't forget to hit that like button and get subscribed so you don't miss update announcements like these, as well as checking out our other videos and tutorials that'll help you unlock the full power of your Elgato products. Once again, I'm Steggy from Elgato, and until our next video, good luck and have fun.